Hi, this is Alfousia Nihar from At Home Tuition. Welcome to our session today. The topic that we are going to discuss in our today's video is Application of Power Rule Part 2 video. In our previous Part 1 video, we started examples of the variety of functions which can be differentiated using the power rule. We discussed two important cases in our previous video. First one is horizontal lines and second one is straight lines of the form y equal to ax, along with few examples. Now let us start with the third case, positive whole powers of x. This is a very common type of function to be required to differentiate, which has n as a positive whole number. Let me take one example directly and discuss how we are going to use power rule in this case. Here is the example question. We are supposed to differentiate y equal to 6x raised to 3x cube and then find its gradient at x is equal to 3. Here, the function obviously fits the first part of the power rule. Am I right? It has a coefficient and it has a exponent. So, you can just write the standard form of the equation and compare and find what is a and n here. A is nothing but the coefficient of the function. Here, in the place of a, we have 6. And n is the exponent. In the place of n, we have 3. So, with a equal to 6 and n equal to 3, you can cover up x cube to see what is a. So, if you cover up x cube, you can identify that a equal to 6. So, using these values in the second part of the power rule will give us, plug in what you got for a and n in this formula. So, you'll be getting, so the derivative is 18x square. The derivative 18x square describes the gradient of the function y equal to 6x cube at every point on its graph. Let me also draw the graph for this function. We should realize that the gradient of y equal to 6x cube changes as x changes as its derivative is a function of x. So to find the gradient when x is equal to 3 or indeed at any point, you substitute the value into the derivative function. Just plug in that value here. If you replace x by 3, you'll be getting 3 square. So 9. 18 times 9 is 162. So in this graph, the dotted line illustrates the tangent on the curve when x is equal to 3. Hope you're clear with this example. Okay, I'll take one example with the coefficient hidden. In this example, we have the coefficient very straightforward. It is just obvious, no? Let me take one more example with hidden coefficient. Let's see how we are going to apply the power rule there. You can also try your own example, but you have to keep a positive whole power as of the x. So here I'm having 4. So please consider this example. In order to use the power rule, we need to rewrite the function to fit the pattern because the coefficient a seems to be missing from this equation. Am I right? So remember, we can always multiply something by 1 and keep it the same. So the function can be written as 1 times x raised to 4. Am I right? Often, when the coefficient is absent, it is assumed that its value is 0, which is not the case. If it were 0, then the whole function would be 0, as anything multiplied by 0 is 0, no? So, however, using 1 times x raised to 4, we can use the first part of the power rule. Now, you can easily identify what is a and n. A is 1 and n is equal to 4. So, you can use these values in the second part of the power rule to find the derivative. First, you have to rewrite the given expression in the format and identify what is a and n. Let's apply the derivative formula. 4 minus 1 is 3. So, x cube 1 time anything is the same thing. So, 4x cube. So, the derivative of y equal to x raised to 4 is 4x cube. Hope you are clear with this example. First, we had a visible coefficient and then we had invisible coefficient. Now, let's discuss one more example with fractional coefficient and let's see how we are going to apply power rule in that case. If you just look at this example, you may think that it does not perfectly fit the pattern for the power rule. But we should take care when deciding the value of a. You can cover up x cube to find that the value of a is 5 over 6. Or you can rewrite the function as a product as we generally do in algebra. Just multiply this coefficient with the variable. So 5 over 6 times x cube is nothing but 5x cube over 6. So I'm just going to rewrite it. Now you can easily identify what is a and n. So a is 5 over 6 and n is 3. You can use these values in the second part of the power rule to find the derivative as we generally do. Okay, let's apply the formula. Hope you're getting the same value. If you multiply, you can still reduce this. 3 goes 2 times. So 5 over 2 x square. Or you can write the answer in this format, 5x square over 2. So when whatever case it may be, you have to rewrite the equation into the pattern that fits into the power rule. And then you have to apply the formula. That is the second part of the power rule. Second part of the power rule is just to find the derivative. So this is the derivative for this case. Where the derivative function has been cancelled down, we have to give the answer in simplest form. Hope you're clear with these three cases. Okay. So now let's move on to the next type. What we do when we get a negative whole power of x? So how we apply power rule there? Let's see with suitable examples. This is the fourth case we are discussing. So what we do when we have negative whole powers of x? When x appears beneath the dividing line, it is extremely common to assign an incorrect value for n. Okay, I would like to recall a law of indices here. 1 over x raised to m or 1 over x raised to negative m. This can be written as x raised to m. Am I right? Because if you are going to shift any term from the denominator to numerator, its sign will change. Sign of the exponent will change. So negative sign will change into positive one. Or you can also rewrite this as, I'll show you one more law. Same concept. If you are shifting a term from the position, either from numerator or denominator, the sign of the exponent will reverse for any non-zero m. So this will help you to rewrite these functions in a form which matches the first part of the power rule. Let me take few examples and help you. Here is an example. So at the first glance, student may mistake that n is equal to 5 in this question. But by using the law of indices mentioned just before, you can see that you can just rewrite this. Hope you can follow so far. So if you are rewriting this, this will fit the pattern of the first part of the power rule. Now you can easily identify what is a and n. A is the coefficient, which is nothing but 3, and n is the exponent. Variable should be always kept in the numerator's place, not in denominator's place. Only then you can identify the correct n value. So now n is equal to negative 5. You can use these values in the second part of the power rule to find the derivative. Let's apply the formula. If you are doing the second part, you will be getting the coefficient as it is, and apply the power rule here. So negative 5, bring your exponent to the coefficients place and subtract 1 from the exponent. Negative 5, negative 1 is nothing but negative 6. If you are multiplying the coefficients, you will be getting negative 15. So this is going to be your answer. But please make sure that you don't write negative exponent in your final answer. So if you are going to change this negative exponent into positive exponent, what you are going to do? Yes, we are going to apply the law of indices, which is nothing but we are going to shift this term from numerator's place to denominator's place to change the sign of the exponent. So if you are doing so, what you will get? Negative 15 over x raised to 6. So whenever you get a negative whole power of x, you will be getting answers of this type. It will be just looking like a reciprocal. Hope you are clear with this case. You should know all the cases. You should know how to use the power rule in all the 5 cases. Now we are going to discuss about the 5th case. Powers of x which are unit fractions. So far the exponents are whole numbers, no? This is the last case when the powers of x which are unit fractions. So we will be getting roots in those types of problems. Here I am going to recall one more law of indices. You can use this law of indices. Mth root of x can be rewritten as x raised to 1 over m. Am I right? Whatever number written over this root is written in the denominator's place. So this will help you to differentiate functions which contain a root. Let me take one example and explain you the application of power rule. Here is an example. Differentiate y equal to 8 square root of x. If no number is mentioned over this root, it means it is a square root. Am I right? Now let's rewrite this expression by using law of indices which is mentioned just before. So you can see that 8 times x raised to 1 over 2. I'm just rewriting the square root as an exponent so that it fits into the normal pattern so that we can apply the power rule. We have rewritten our expression. This fits the pattern of the first part of the power rule. Now you can easily identify what is a and n. A is 8 and n is 1 over 2. You can use these values in the second part of the power rule to find the derivative. So let's apply the formula. In all the differentiation videos, I keep on telling that you should be familiar with all the algebraic calculation methods. See here, we are going to do fractional subtraction. So 1 over 2 minus 1 is negative 1 over 2. and half times 8 is 4. So 4 times x raised to negative 1 over 2. Again, you should keep in mind that you should not give your final answer as a negative exponent. In case if you are giving your answer in this format, it will be considered as an incomplete answer. So you should include one more step. We have to rewrite this negative exponent as a positive exponent. So how can we do that? Yes, we are going to use one of the law of indices. We are just going to shift this term from numerator's place to denominator's place. Always try to keep your answer in the format which is given in the question. In our question, we have a square root. So I'm going to rewrite this 1 over 2 as square root, because the derivative function is written in this form of the question as a root. Hope you're clear with all the cases. All of the derivative rules are verified by using the definition of a derivative. Although we will not derive all of the rules, we do give the derivation of the power rule in the special cases when n is equal to 0, n is a positive integer, whole number, negative whole integer, if it is a unit fraction, if it is a negative 1, so that we can get an idea of what is involved. The derivation of power rule involves applying the definition of the derivative of the function. Hope you are clear with using the power rule. In case if you have any query regarding this topic, kindly let me know. See you in the next